Here today with Ryan Deal, who's running for City Council for Rochester Hills. How are you doing today?
I am very well. How are you?
Great, great. So can you talk a little bit about why you're running for council?
Yes, there are two reasons that I'm running for City Council. The first off is that our current City Councilman is now running for re-election in District 4. And Rochester Hills is, you know, has a lot of things to be proud of. We are ranked the safest city in Michigan. Recently, Money Magazine ranked the top 10 places in the United States to live. And in the last public opinion survey, 99% of Rochester Hills residents are satisfied or very satisfied with their decision to live in Rochester Hills. And those kinds of achievements don't happen by accident. They happen with a qualified leadership team, a dedicated city staff, and you know, and obviously the residents themselves. And so I'm running to make sure that we can keep Rochester Hills going in the right direction. I'm a library board trustee, so I've been running the, you know, we've been running the library board on the same millage we've had since 1924. And I'm a president of the Arcadia Park Homeowners Association. I'm on the city's building authority. So I have the experience, you know, in city government to, you know, make sure that we can keep Rochester Hills moving in the right direction. And I'm also, you know, a licensed and practicing attorney. The second reason that I'm running is a little bit more personal. You know, Rochester Hills is my home. It's where my wife and I, you know, bought our first home, and I carried her over the threshold. It's where we brought our twin sons home from the hospital. It's where, you know, we send our kids to baseball, t-ball. Our kids are in the Rochester Community Schools. We have a vested interest in making sure that our community is, you know, maintains the quality of life that this is my home today, and it's. I don't have any intentions of leaving anytime soon. This is where I live. And so that's why I'm running for City Council.
You had mentioned being an attorney. Can you talk just a little bit about some of your professional background and some of those skills, how those are going to help you on council?
Yes. I'm a graduate of Michigan State University. After I attended Michigan State, I went to Wayne State University Law School. After Wayne State, I went to work for a firm. We did a lot of corporate litigation, tax litigation, and then I went into private practice with my wife. After a while, a position opened up in the Oakland County Probate Court, and I accepted that position. I'm a judicial staff attorney, which means that I help the court set policy. I help the court, you know, with in making decisions. And I also, and it's actually the most satisfying part of my job, is to help families that are in disputes reach a resolution. And one of the most satisfying parts of my job is when I can help a family that have a great deal of disagreement come to a decision. You know, there's usually a lot of acrimony, a lot of hurt feelings, but at the end of the day, when they can come together, they may not sit down at the Thanksgiving table and have Thanksgiving dinner this year, but I can at least help them through this crisis that they're in right now. And that, I think, is a skill that translates very, very well to City Council.
Now, if you were elected, what do you think would be some of the topics that you would focus on in your couple years?
Mm-hmm. I think, as with any city, you know, the number one job is the budget. The budget reflects a lot of things. It reflects, you know, the city's financial health, but it also reflects the priorities of the city and what direction that the city's going to go in. And having been, that budget touches every aspect of life, you know, in the city. Your public safety, roads, parks, amenities, infrastructure, everything is touched by that budget. And, you know, when you want to make sure, that is, you know, the primary focus. But as I've kind of explained, that touches everything. that the city does. So really, making sure that the city maintains its sound financial footing so that we can address all of those issues, you know, with police, fire, roads, parks. Everything that we do is on sound footing.
So this, the person holding this seat is not running again. We don't necessarily know who all your competition is at this point. But why should people vote for you?
I think that it comes down to experience. And if you look at all of our members of City Council, they are all extremely talented and qualified people, and it's a testament to the makeup of our community. And you know, we don't, when you, we, there was really only one seat where the incumbent is not running, and that's mine. And we want somebody who can get into that position and hit the ground running. Having been on the library board, I have been working with municipal budgets. Our library board functions like a municipal corporation. So the city collects a tax, but we're all independent. Each library board member is elected within the city, and the city collects the tax, but we have the authority on how to spend it. And I'm very proud of the fact that about the level of service that we've been able to provide with the budget we have. Like I said, the budget that in the millage that the library operates under is almost 100 years old. And yet we've been able to provide a wide range of quality services. I think we have one of the best libraries around. And I think that, you know, that demonstrates my ability to bring those skills to council. But also, not just that, my experience as an attorney, as somebody who regularly mediates disputes and helps people to find common ground, I think that is going to be very helpful. I think that my experience simply as the president of my homeowners association will also help. I mean, we have our homeowners association has a budget that we deal with every year, and we have to be able to every year it seems like do more with less. And also my experience on the building authority, will also be helpful. So I think, to answer your question about why someone should vote for me, it really comes down to experience. And, that coupled with, my roots that I have planted into the community, that helped me to connect with the other residents, it's so easy because, my kids are attending the school. So I, just in living my day-to-day life, I have interaction with, everybody. And they all feel free to let me know, what they think, what things they like are going on and what things they don't like. And so just in my day-to-day life, I'm very, very accessible to the residents. And so I think that, too, qualifies me for the office.
So if people want more information about you and your campaign, where do they go?
Yes. There's two primary places. Obviously, there's a website, ryandeel.com, and it's ryandeel.com. And then Facebook, Ryan J. Deel. And on that, you can find more information about me, but I'm also posting, about the city and different things that are going on there and other information. As I kind of learn it, I give details.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thanks for having me.